It's that time of year again where I'm sitting here on New Year's Eve and I'm trying to think of what good things happened in this past year. 2016 was a really hard year for a lot of people, kind of just in general, and it's really easy to focus on the negativity and all the bad things that happened this year. But for these kind of reflections, I want to think more on myself and the things that I accomplished this year because there were a lot of really great things that happened too. And that's why I love making these videos. It forces me to sit down and think through everything and just really reflect and see the positive stuff. This is my reflection of 2016. I think that 2016 was a year where creativity was very pivotal for me. I wrote a book this year. Not only did I write a whole 150,000 word novel, I also edited that novel several times, gave it to a friend and my mom to read and edit for me, and made some pretty great progress in the sequel. Like, I'm about 50,000 words into the sequel.
It is July 12th, and I just want to show you that this is what is getting me through this right now. I am so close to finishing the outline of the story. I've been working on this for like at least a week now. This is how long the outline is. This is actually insane.
That's a really big deal for me. I've been writing stories and books since I was 8 years old. I mean, I've been writing like stories since I was really little, but I started writing books when I was about 8, and I say books because they were like 10 pages on Microsoft Office Word, and I thought they were full-length novels. The story I wrote this past year is a story I've had in my head since I was in, I want to say, the 7th or 8th grade. I never knew how to write this story. I started it with different genres, I started it with different characters and different plots and ideas, but I knew who the main character was, and I knew what story she had and what story had to be told. And finally, this past year, it just came to me how I wanted to write it and what was really going to happen and who was going to be involved in that. And I wrote the book in about 6 months, and then I spent a whole month editing it, and then I spent some more time editing, and then I started writing the sequel.
I just printed the outline. I am so happy. Yay. It is 15 pages long.
It is a fantasy novel, which sounds very, how do I say this nicely? Kind of nerdy. I'm a 17-year-old girl writing a fantasy novel. But the thing about fantasy is it's very complicated, and there's a lot of room for self-doubt. You wonder if the world you've created is realistic, if the rules you've created are realistic, and just the characters in general, are they realistic? You want to make real characters who fit their age, but you're also putting them in circumstances that characters, people their age, would not normally face, and it's just a lot. And now I'm talking solely about this book and not my year. Let's go back into the year. This whole year had a lot to do with storytelling for me. My drama teacher mentioned that as performers, our job is to tell a story, and that really just clicked a lot in place for me. I've always had the struggle between my writing side and my performer side and finding ways that they could come together. And when she said that, it was just this moment of, oh, I'm a storyteller. I love telling stories. I mean, even as someone who creates videos, I sit here and I tell stories about my life or other stories, and I just talk to the camera and then I edit it together to share. I write stories, I write songs, I perform, and I'm telling stories when I'm performing. I'm a storyteller. I had one of the best experiences of my life this year, and thinking about it and talking about it makes me kind of emotional. I was in the musical Beauty and the Beast at my high school, and it was my third big musical I've done at my school. It was just different this year. The cast was so close, and you know, any show you do ever, you feel like you become a theater family. You definitely get that tightness. I don't even know how to explain it. It's like nothing I've ever experienced. This past year was just the closest group I've ever been with. I feel like pretty much everyone got along and there wasn't drama, and everyone was just so happy backstage. We were all having so much fun, and the show was incredible. We were all so proud of the show.
Nothing.
Hi guys, I'm Juan.
My name's Claire, and
Chris.
today I'm vlogging all by myself.
Chris.
No help at all, whatsoever.
Not even the right hand of Max Hall.
No. Oh, it's Flo! gosh, how did that happen?
Are you ready for our first matinee?
Yep.
It was so amazing. Every single night, we would hug each other backstage and get excited over what had happened and how the audience had reacted. And every single time a show ended, we just wanted to go right back out there and do it again. I was truly so proud of everyone who put time into that show. It was just such a special group of people, and it truly was one of the best experiences of my life, was that month leading up to the show and being in the show and just really realizing that I have a second family, and it's my theater family, and that being in a theater feels like home to me. Being on stage is where I'm happy and comfortable. It was just such a great revelation.
You want a revolution? I want a revelation.
On that note, Hamilton. I didn't even mean to go to Hamilton, but that just happened. Hamilton. I started really listening to Hamilton last February, and I'll admit, I listened to it like the fall of 2015, and I was like, oh, hip-hop's not my thing. I made myself listen to Hamilton in February, and there was just no going back. Hamilton is one of those musicals that I think a lot of people can say had a huge impact on them and changed them somehow, because I know for me, listening to Hamilton and being inspired by the actors and the actresses in that show really kind of gave me a nudge into the theater direction. I remember just listening to Hamilton thinking, oh my gosh, I want to do this so badly. I want to perform in theater so badly. And then I was kind of just like, well, why don't you? There are a lot of other musicals that have done that for me, that have really pushed me, and you know, just me myself loving theater and my family and friends supporting me and encouraging me. But I feel like Hamilton just happened in the right time. That was a time where I was kind of struggling and was not sure what I wanted to do next year, like university. And listening to Hamilton during that time just really reinforced how important theater is to me. We also have begun our musical for this coming year, Guys and Dolls. We did casting and everything back in September, and oh, everything is making me emotional today. I have been in musical theater every year since grade 9. I've done all the musicals, and I've gone from being an ensemble and having the first bow to playing one of the lead characters who I've always wanted to play and having one of the last bows. If you know me, you know I'm really into like signs and full circle things, and to me that's just the perfect way to end my high school experience, is to go from being grade 9 and having that first ensemble bow to working my way up and finishing with one of the last bows. And I'm in theater because I love performing and because I love telling stories, and not because, you know, I want to be some lead diva or anything like that. And anyone who's passionate about theater will tell you that. You want to play the roles that you want to play, you know, the story you want to tell. And for me, I wanted to tell Sarah's story, and that's the character I'm playing. Because I'm a soprano and because I love being dramatic and having in-depth characters, a lot of times the characters I do want to play happen to be the leads. Sopranos, you feel me? You feel me on this one? It's a struggle. It's a really big deal to me. This is my first time playing a lead in a musical, and like I said, I know being a lead isn't important at all, but it just means a lot that I have been given this opportunity. I started my senior year of high school. What the heck? Am I halfway through? I'm not halfway through, but I'm almost halfway through my senior year. I'm graduating this coming year. What? I went to senior sale, which is when my school like rents this dinner cruise and all the seniors go on it, and it's a great time, and I just had so much fun being with my best friends all night. It was just so great, like getting to see our city from the water. I love where we live. It's so beautiful. And to get to share that with my friends was just, it was an amazing experience. I got to see a ton of shows this year. My mom and I went to go see the musical Mamma Mia when it toured here, and Mamma Mia is one of my favorite musicals just because I think it's so cheesy and ridiculous, but I love it. We also saw the musical Evita, which was phenomenal. Ramin Karimloo and Caroline Bowman were in it, and they are two Broadway actors who are just amazing. I still can't believe I saw Ramin Karimloo. Like, it's just, oh. Whew. I got to go see the musical Newsies with Candace, and that show was a very pleasant surprise. I knew that the choreography in it was supposed to be phenomenal, I didn't expect the story to grab me as much as it did, and for the characters to grab me as much as they did. Yes, Catherine is now one of my dream roles. Just let me live my life. I saw the Book of Mormon with my whole family, and that was just so much fun. It's such a funny show, but the talent in it was also just incredible. And I saw West Side Story over the summer with Katie, Candace, Katie's mom, my mom, and my brother Michael. On the entertainment end of things, I was inspired a lot this year by what was being put out. The movie Moana came out a month ago and just, I just saw it again with my family and yes, I cried again. I loved it. It was so good. The song How Far I'll Go just really speaks to me, especially with the stage I'm at in my life, once again, having to do with deciding what I want to do with my life and wanting to go forth and do things, but knowing that I might not make it, but I really want to make it. I'm gonna try anyway. I also saw the movie Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, and that was a pretty big deal for me because it's the first Harry Potter related movie I've ever seen in the theaters. I'm also in the middle of rereading the series right now, and it's even better the second time around, if possible. As of right now, I have two Pottermore accounts. One of them I'm Ravenclaw, and the other one I'm Gryffindor. Also, the book Harry Potter and the Cursed Child came out, which was my first time reading a Harry Potter book without knowing what was going to happen. Another book that really inspired me this year, and I think it is one of my absolute favorite books of all time now, is Sarah J. Maas's A Court of Mist and Fury. It deals with inner strength, knowing that surviving things makes you strong, not weak. It was just what I needed. I think it's what everyone needs to hear. Everyone should go read this book. It's so good. It's the sequel to her book A Court of Thorns and Roses, which is nothing like the sequel. It's still a great book, but they are like totally different, and oh, it's just so good. I worked 3 jobs this year, like a mature, responsible adult. I'm quitting 2 of them. One of them was seasonal, it turned into part-time as a retail worker. One of them is a job I've had since grade 10, where I dress up as a princess and go to a kid's place and do parties and meet and greets. It's the best thing ever. And the other one was a seasonal winter job, where I dress up as an elf and spread Christmas cheer, and that was also wonderful. But oh my gosh, December was killer. I also re-met Bianca, and re-met feels like the weirdest, but it's like the way to describe it, because we met once at a book signing in grade 10, and then we kind of kept in touch, but never actually ever got together, and this past year, Bianca and I have become closer because we actually see each other in person now. We go and hang out together, and it's amazing. She's such an incredible person. I love her so much. We have like a coffee shop where we always meet. It's like our spot, and I'm just so happy that we finally, like, decided, hey, we are friends, why don't we ever see each other in person? I love you, Bianca, if you're watching this. I don't know if you're watching this. It's probably a ridiculously long video, so I don't blame you if you're not. I took a lot of risks this year as a performer and learned to be comfortable with taking risks. I've shared a few of my original songs before, but usually I don't share them until a year or so after I wrote them, because when they're new, they're still personal and they're still raw to me. And in January, we had our school talent show, and I shared a song that I had written pretty recently and that still was important to me. And it was scary because you're afraid of receiving criticism. And I don't mind if people don't like it. It's if they don't like the meaning behind it that kind of hurts, because it's like you're sharing a piece of who you are. And if anyone didn't like it, they didn't say anything, which is very nice. I think it was pretty well received. I also played the piano, which was the weirdest thing because I don't play piano, but I wrote the song on the piano and I didn't want to translate it to guitar because it didn't feel right to me. So I played the piano and sang an original song for the talent show. Weird. I then continued to do a few original songs at a school event called Slam Jam, where it's a slam poetry night featuring music from students, so I played 2 of my original songs there, and I actually feel a lot more comfortable with sharing my own music now that I've put myself out there. I also joined my school's improv club. I hate improv so much. That's not true. I love improv. I think it's incredible and amazing. I just hate when I have to do improv because it scares me so much. Oh my gosh, improv makes me so anxious. Like, it terrifies me. I absolutely hate doing improv. That is why I joined improv club, so I would get comfortable with doing improv. Am I comfortable with doing improv now? Not really. I'm working on it. I unfortunately couldn't be in my school's improv club this year, like this school year, because their meetings are on the same day that I'm in my leadership course. But hey, I got accepted into my school's leadership extracurricular course, so that was cool. I feel a lot more involved in my school having done that, because I'm very involved in the theater, so I feel involved at school, but I don't necessarily feel involved in the school community as a whole. So being in leadership has really given me other opportunities to get to know other people and to work in different areas of the school. On that note, for my leadership course, we have to run 2 events in the school year, and I kind of, with some other people, created this event called A Night on Broadway, and it was like a cabaret showcase night for musical theater students. It was something I've always wanted to see done at our school, and I was kind of like, I have this opportunity to run an event, why don't we just do it? Not only did I help run the event, but I also performed in it a lot. I did a lot of numbers in this event. Stop, don't know, please stop, don't know, please stop, don't know, please, mama, I'm a good girl now. Hey, mama. It was such a success. We were afraid we weren't gonna sell enough tickets. We thought the event was going to get canceled. We ended up overselling out. We sold out, and then we were trying to make room for more people to come in. Another event that I got to run this year through my actual leadership class that I took in grade 11 was called Talk to Me, and it was to raise awareness for mental illness and mood disorders. As soon as I heard about this event, I knew that I wanted to be a part of it. It was really, really hard. My committee wasn't that into it. I had to take on a lot. It was very stressful, but it was also very rewarding. I got to MC the event, and my teacher convinced me to share my own story about dealing with anxiety. I'm very open about the fact that I have anxiety and that I deal with it, and I've been dealing with it pretty much my whole life, but it's not something I always talk about, and I guess this year I really discovered the difference between being open with something and actually talking about something. People are going through something and they know that I've been through it, you know, I'm happy to kind of talk to them about my experience. I don't really go into it a whole lot though, how it's affected me. I don't think I ever even really realized how much it's affected me until this past year, and I really had to face it head on and deal with it through a lot of different circumstances. There were a lot of things this year that really stressed me out and made me anxious, and I had to really learn how to deal with that. It's not something I'm ashamed of, it's just something that's hard to really talk about. My whole life has been a process of learning different ways of coping and dealing. I've become pretty good at recognizing what I need and how to get that, but it's an ongoing thing, and I think it's probably going to be ongoing for the rest of my life, and that's what's hard to acknowledge and to accept, that sometimes I'm going to be fine and sometimes I'm not. I had to really look at that this year and evaluate that. So not only did I share a bit of my story at Talk to Me, but I also had to do a TED Talk in front of my leadership group, not my class that I did in grade 11, but the course I am now taking that's extracurricular. I had to do a TED Talk, and I chose to do it on anxiety, and it was really, really hard for me, but I think it's kind of opened a door that I hadn't realized I had kept shut for so long, and now I'm talking about it in front of a camera, so I'm trying to be better about it. I had a baby, sort of. I'm just being dramatic. I had a robot baby for a weekend. I was in child development, and I was given a robot baby, and I hated it so much. I love babies. I love children. Give me a real baby, it's okay. I will still be sleep deprived and not happy about it, but like, it's a real baby, it's okay. But this was a robot that kept me up all night, all weekend. I did not sleep all weekend.
It's 1:20 a.m. Baby woke me up 10 minutes ago for a diaper change and started crying again to be fed.
Every year I think I learn more about myself, and every year I'm surprised at the discoveries I make. I became very firm in my own beliefs and opinions this year. I really found my voice, and I found a voice that I was proud to be loud with. I was never a super opinionated person. I kind of always looked to people who I admired, and I would see what their opinions were, and I would just believe that what they thought was right, Which, now that I think about it, is not a good way to go about forming your own opinions and beliefs. I really took the time to educate myself this year, and I took courses that educated me. I now know what I stand for, and a lot of the things that I stand for are things that I think are worth fighting for. They're things that I'm passionate about, and that's a whole new side of me that I really discovered this year. I truly realized how important the theater is to me, and that theater is what I want to pursue. Like I said before, I am very arts orientated, and I've always had the struggle between writing and between performing. And I've found opportunities that will allow me to do a bit of both, but I know that I want my main focus to be on training as a performer. I know that I will always continue to write, to songwrite, to story write, to journal. I will always continue to do that. But at the beginning of this year, I really did not think that I was going to pursue theater for post-secondary. I thought that this would be my last year being in a musical. A few nights ago, I decided to read through the journal that I kept this past year, and the very first page I was writing about theater and how sad the idea of not doing it after high school made me. The thing is, I'd been talking to Katie and Candace just this morning about the fact that next year might be my last year doing theater for a long time, since I'm not planning on going into theater for university. And that kind of scares me. The idea of something that I love being taken away from me for such a long period of time. I feel like the future is a tidal wave that is coming closer and closer, and sooner than later, it's just going to knock me over and take me under. The thought of not doing theater made me so sad, and when I made that decision to try and pursue theater, the whole idea of the future just shifted for me. Yes, it's still a scary, unknown thing, but I don't feel like it's knocking me over anymore. I feel like it's kind of a bit of both. It's this beautiful ocean that's beckoning me towards it, and I know it has so much to offer me, and I'm excited to see what I'm going to discover, but I also know it has the chance to kind of take me under, and I'm trying to just surf the waves right now. Wow, can you tell I was in English honors? Those metaphors. This year is all about the future. Going to school, knowing that it's my last first day of high school, and that, you know, cutting down our Christmas tree this year, not being sure if next year I'm going to be here to cut it down or if I'm going to be away somewhere. This is the first time in my life I haven't known what next year is going to look like, and that scares me because the unknown is something that's always frightened me. It's always been one of my biggest fears, just not knowing, and I'm dealing with it better than I think that I should be, considering how much that idea scares me. I guess because I know everyone right now is going through that, all of my friends are going through it too, and we're kind of in this together. It's also exciting though. The future just has so many opportunities right now. It's scary to know that what I'm doing right now will affect, perhaps, the path my life takes, but I also have faith that things happen for a reason, and I have to just believe that I'm going to end up where I need to be. 2017 is going to be an incredible year. I'm flying to some schools to do some auditions in February, so I'm going to be doing a bit of traveling, which I'm very excited about. In March, I'm going to New York with my theater program and my best friends. I'm going to be graduating and having my grad, and I will be starting university, hopefully, depending on if I get accepted anywhere and if I choose to go someplace. There are just so many things happening this coming year. This year, 2017, is just going to be absolutely crazy. I am planning on just surfing that wave and enjoying it. I'm not going to let that tidal wave knock me over. How did this become the metaphor for this video? In the wise words of Lin-Manuel Miranda portraying Alexander Hamilton, let's go. Dun, dun, dun. The Hamilton obsession will never die. Dear 2016, you were really hard at times, but that made me a better person and it made me get to know me even more. Thank you for giving me so many opportunities and for pushing me in directions that I needed to go. Thank you for watching. I will see you guys next time. Bye!